Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and today I'm going to create a tutorial using the free version of Onshape to create a part model. Now, the part model that I'm going to create is going to come from the Too Tall Toby website over here on this tab that says Leaderboard. And what the Leaderboard is it's a challenge that I issue to all users of any CAD system every month. Speed model these three parts. So here we can see in the middle of the page, it says April 2023 Leaderboard Challenge, speed model these three parts. And if I click on that banner, it takes me to an IMGUR page with three drawings with the correct material density and the answer in grams or in pounds listed here. The correct answer is listed here right on these images. So your challenge is to speed model through these three parts as quickly as possible. And when you're done with that challenge, your time will be recorded and will be automatically listed here on this leaderboard. So here we can see number one in April is Erwick, who did all three models in just 3 minutes and 12 seconds. And if you want to see the video of how Erwick accomplished that, you can click here and watch the video of him speed modeling these in about 1 minute per model. Very impressive, much faster than I'm going to be able to do it as an Onshape noob. And on that note, I'm sure I'm going to have a lot of questions as I'm going through here. So please go down into the comments and let me know what I could be doing better as I try to create this first model. But on that note, I'm going to get into it here. I'm going to click this button that says compete. This brings up the clock that I'm going to be using as I'm going through the challenge. I'm going to move this clock over here just kind of to the left side of my screen. And I'm going to launch Onshape free and try to take this Too Tall Toby leaderboard challenge.
Ow.
Okay, so we've got ourselves set up here to take this challenge. Like I said, today I'm just gonna do the first of the three parts, and if I am doing anything that is less than optimal, I hope that you will let me know down in the comments. I'll probably have some questions along the way too. I'm a SOLIDWORKS expert, but I'm really an Onshape noob here going through and trying to create this model. I've got the IMGUR here on my second monitor so that I can create this model from this drawing. And I've got my clock over here, so I'm ready to take this challenge. I'm gonna click start to start the clock for the first model. And I'm gonna go in here and create a new document. I'll just call this O1 to save time. You don't have to name it anything special. You just have to create a new document. And then I'm gonna click on the top plane. I'm gonna press the S key on my keyboard, one of my favorite shortcuts in Onshape. And I'm gonna begin a new sketch. And then I'm gonna press N to get normal too. And I'm going to create the geometry for this revolved feature. So I could come across here with a line like so. Once I drop that line, I'll type in the distance, 250 over 2 to give me half of that distance. I'll go this way and once again type in 125 over 2 to give me half of that distance. I'll go this way, let go of my mouse, I'll type in the distance of 15. I will go this way. I'm not really sure what this dimension is supposed to be. So I will just kind of drop that there like so. And in this direction, I know it's supposed to be 20 because it's supposed to be 35 from the end. And then I will click in this direction and then come across and close off that sketch. Now I will create an additional line here, and that way I can make this additional line here for construction. Here I'm going to hold control and press the middle mouse button to pan. That's a good shortcut to know about in Onshape for just view navigation. And then I'll right mouse button on this line and I'll make it for construction. Now here's a question that I have. In Onshape, is it possible to reassign our dimensions? In other words, can I click on this 20 dimension and somehow grab the dimension grip and reassign it over here to this line? Because really it's not supposed to be 20. What it's really supposed to be is, I deleted that line by accident. What it's really supposed to be is 35 from here to here. So, you know, I've got the correct distance there for my auto dimensioning, but is it possible to reassign that? And similarly, is it possible to take this dimension and somehow turn it into a doubled dimension? Like, can I reassign this dimension to the center line, or do I have to delete it and get in here and recreate it? Since I'm on the clock and I don't know the answer to that, I'm just going to do it that way. I'm just gonna recreate it here. I'm gonna click on the center line, move across the center line, and then get my doubled dimension here of 125. I'm gonna click on this line, click the center line, move across the center line, and get my dimension here of 100. I'm going to click this line here, click the center line, move across the center line, and get my dimension of 75. And then the final dimension that I need to create is to this line here. Maybe this line just needs to be vertical. So just click on that line and make sure that it's vertical. Okay, there we go. Nice and black sketch, fully defined, fully constrained. Gonna go to the revolve command. This is another question that I have on this model is it possible for me to somehow pre-select this center line to use for the revolve? You know, what would be ideal would be if I could click that and then click revolve and then have that show up down here in the revolve axis. Doesn't look like that happens automatically, so I have to click revolve axis and then I can click on that. And that should have given me the full revolve there. Let's see, edges of sketch one, edge of sketch one. I don't know why I'm not seeing my preview. Let's see, make this a solid. That was kind of interesting. I wonder if there's something funky going on with that sketch. Let me just try that again. I'm in sketch mode. I click revolve. I click my revolve access and click here. Okay, that's what I was expecting. All right. Lost a few seconds there, but I just wanted to satisfy my own curiosity. All right, so now I'm ready to create my second feature. I'm going to go to the front plane. I'm going to begin a sketch, S key sketch. I'll press N to get normal two. I'll take this edge here and just do a convert entities. So we'll go S key convert, and then I will create a circle that goes right out to that same point with that 75 dimension. Guess I don't need that because it's coincident. And then I can do an extrude command, and that'll just be from this region here. Is there an easier way to select just that region? Another little hiccup that I'm running into here. So let me edit that sketch and see if maybe I'll do a trim, just kind of manually trim that. But that'd be another great question. If you guys know why I wasn't getting the desired results there, let me know that down in the comments and I can definitely work that into my my workflow. But okay, that looks pretty good. And so now I'm going to select this face, begin a sketch, orient my view, and I'm going to create some circles here. So this is going to have a circle with a diameter of, what's this one? This one has a diameter of 80. I'm gonna create another circle here with a diameter of 50. And I'm going to choose to extrude those two circles. This is gonna be a remove, and that's gonna be a remove to a depth of 15. And then I'm just gonna pick this face here and I'm gonna do a remove here just directly from that face, and I'll go through all so I don't have to make another sketch or anything or even do a convert or even select that original edge and or the original sketch. I can just take the face itself and do an extrude from there. And then I'll pick this face here, select a face, begin a sketch, orient my view, and create my final geometry here, which is going to be my circle with a diameter of 50, and that's going to be an extrude cut. So we'll go here to extrude cut, and I'll take that one. I think I'll just do that one up to face, and I'll pick the front plane of the model. That should give me exactly what I want there. Okay, that looks pretty darn good. I'm ready to go into a mirror command now. So I'll go to my features. I'll go to my mirror here in my features. And I will say this is going to be the part to mirror. I'm going to mirror the entire part this time. So here you can see we've got part mirror, feature mirror, face mirror. I'm going to use part mirror and just mirror everything. And then for my mirror plane, I'll pick the right plane, or I could pick that face of the model. This is going to be an add, and I'll hit the green check mark. I'll do what's called the final spin, kind of look this thing over. If I want bonus points, I could right mouse button on this part and go to edit appearance for part one, and I could choose to make this the same color as it is on the print. That's just a little bit of bonus points. You certainly don't have to do that because it takes extra time. I'm going to go over here to where it says part one in the tree, and I'm going to say assign material, and I'm going to go to my custom material and just call this 111 for sake of time, and I'll call this 0.001020. That's coming right off of the title block of the print. And now I should be able to go down here to the corner. There's a section down here in the corner for mass properties. So I'll go down here into the corner for mass properties, and I'll say, what is the mass of this part? And the mass is coming up as 1212, and that is correct. And so I can choose click here when finished model one, and that stops the clock for model one, 6 minutes and 55 seconds. So it took me three times as long, more than three times as long to create one single model as it took Airwick to create all three. Again, very impressive from Airwick, but if you are watching this video and you can let me know what I could have done better, what I could have done faster, or maybe what went wrong when I couldn't pick that little contour from the sketch, or is there like a right mouse button select other or anything like that that maybe I'm missing, please let me know down in the comments. And of course, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to join us for the next episode.